So we're back to another episode of Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword, and just want to let you know that the reason why I'm out here not in Ancient Cestern is because I was out just trying to look for hearts. I completely forgot about this treasure chest right here, and so I just want to show you where it's at. Where we open up the first treasure chest right here is just literally across from where we're at. So just keep that in mind. So what you can actually do is go from where you entered from Ancient Cestern or the Floreo Waterfall. You just go through here and then you go round out this way and then boom. So, and the treasure that it gave me was an evil crystal. I don't know if it's like that in every save file, but it gave me the evil crystal, so just keep that in mind. Alright, so let's get back to Ancient Cestern, because I want to complete that temple and see if we can continue on with more side quests after completing it. Let's see, where is that again? I completely forgot, man. Crap. I'm completely on the other side. Oh shit. Giant dragon. So that's all the hearts I can find, but I think we can be able to make it till we find more hearts. So, let's get back to the Cestern and continue on and see what Destiny has in store for us. Alright, so let's see, right now we have a key, like we left off from the last episode. So with this key, we're gonna go straight on to the tower in the middle, see what we have in here. This is like a really cool design. Like Ancient Cestern is like one of my favorite water temples out of the entire zone. Master, I have taken the liberty to confirm that the door located in the uppermost section of the statue is locked. The lock is unfamiliar to me. And so is to me. Alright, so early on in this dungeon, you see a mini boss. I think that's pretty cool how they did that. So this guy is a little bit different than the stealth mode that we fought in the Sky Temple, I think it's called. This guy, of course, starts with two arms like the other one, but this time, after having a few hits pretty much, he'll draw four weapons. So right now there's a total of four, and it's gonna be like physically impossible to try to figure out what the hits are gonna be. But the best thing to do is just swing your sword until you get him. But whenever you, oh shit, I forgot. Let's run. There you go. Alright. Whenever you see him shaking a little bit, you want to run away, because those weapons, he's going to hit him. He's going to use them all to hit you. And if you don't dodge, then you're screwed. And what you can do too is while he's blocking, there's a small hole that you can try to see if you can stab him with. Oh my god. Alright. So just keep that in mind whenever you see him block, and if you see a hole that's big enough, you just thrust your sword into him and it'll deal some damage. And there you go. He's dead. Let's collect some hearts. showing now that my browser's not good. But that's not a problem right now. I'll get that done later. So how was your guys' 4th of July? Mine was pretty good. Just went to go see some family. Got to go swimming a little bit. Ate some really delicious ribs, thanks to my brother-in-law. And then I went to my friend's house later that night, and then about 8 or 9, they had food cooking, and I only had one rib because, like, I wasn't really that hungry, but I mean, like, I still ate. Like, that's one thing about me, whenever I'm full, I'll still eat. And the food that they made yesterday was very delicious as well. Like, I am very grateful for my friends and family, especially my family, you know? And it's just crazy. Alright, so I just want to be able to lift these up real fast, just so we can get that out of the way. So when we're done with this, we can be able to we don't have to do it anymore. But you see, you come up here and this is with the door that Fi was talking about, how she's unfamiliarized. So with that being said, let's get out of here. And now we have a newly improved whip. We can explore this place a little bit more. So let's see, places that are gonna need the whip. I'd say over here. Oh god, I missed that. Alright. So over here, what you can do with these plants is that you can whip them and you get to flip them upside down. So that opens up a new way. And what's really cool about this whip too is that you see that switch right there that you cannot get? Well, that's where the whip comes in handy. And so with that, we can be able to explore more of the cestern, ancient cestern. My god, I don't know why people even hate on the water level. Like, to be honest, out of all the Zelda games ever made, the water temples have always been my favorite for some reason. Every water temple has always been the thing that I've always liked to go to. And the ancient cestern, it's like, it just tops it all, you know? Just the designs, how everything is, what you need to be able to progress, enemies, shit like that, you know? Like, everything is about this water temple is just pure genius. And so now, you just go up this beam, and you just wait. If you want, you can just stand still. Your stamina won't even deplete that quick, so you could have stayed on, but I'd prefer not to. Alright, so let's see real fast. Oh, perfect. Scatter shot, go! Yeah! That's what's up. Alright. So now what's really cool about this whip is that before you swing, you can actually align yourself. So like if you have to hit the switch before you go up. So align yourself to the switch. Crap. I think actually... No, you can't. Never mind. You actually do have to jump to it. Crap. I'm not too worried about the bomb. Alright, so like I said, you want to align yourself to this, and then you want to swing to it, like so, and there you go. And now we have to do it again to swing to the vines. I wish you can just run up to the vines, but it's too high for Link to even get to. So you just swing, swing, swing. Die. Die. Alright, that was a bit creepy what I just did. Freaking metal voice. And then you just activate this column right here, and voila. And as a first time player, you'll be like, what the fuck am I supposed to do with that? You know? It's like, should I jump down there or try to explore it more? In fact, you do have to jump in. Man, that kind of sucks, being stuck in a whirlpool. Having to hold your breath until that happens. Like, shit, man. I don't think I'll be able to hold my breath that long. Oh, shit. I did not expect that. That's exactly what I wanted to get to. There you go. And now we got, let's see, we have to cut these guys down. Crap. That's my controller, dude. Now you don't have to cut every single one down, you just have to cut the one that's in the middle, but I don't know, like with me, I like to cut them all down and just watch him drown. And with this guy right here, well, you can all, you're wondering like, how am I supposed to get over there? Is there a key that's out there that I have to get first? Well, no. Use your whip, and there you go. Got a small key. And look at this. Shit looks crazy. And that's where we need to go. After I have some important information that I'm certain you will want to hear. There is a large treasure chest in the area. There is an 85% probability that it contains a key that will open the door we observed at the top of the stone statue. Well, no shit, bud. And if you just jump over here, you can keep going if you want. You don't have to kill this guy. But I like to do it because of this. You either get a regular one or you get a gold one. And so, that's why I like to kill a lot of enemies, because they give you the items that you need. Like, most of them, they give you what you need. And so, it never hurts to kill the enemies, you know? Alright, so, let's go up. Go here real fast. Open this switch. I'm gonna save real fast too. Alright, now jump up. There you go. That's what I'm talking about. Whip the flower. Whoa, no, 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 no. Don't show off your acrobats. You can break your neck, Link. Now just go up here. Whoa, motherfucker. See, like, this guy right here takes more hits than he needs to. And it's really hard to get him sometimes. So, the best scene that I like to do is bomb him. I don't know why I even spend that time trying to kill him. But, oh well. So you just jump down, you just flip the flower, and you go down, down, down. I won't even worry about that. 20 rupees. I got plenty of rupees. So, no, Link. Go this way. And now that we're here, let's see. Die. Yep. You just activate this column, and there you go. And what do we need to do there? It's so obvious. I've already explained it before. What you can do with the whip. Damn it. Stupid spider. Alright. Now, whip the lily pad. And we progress more. Very nice. And so you see here with this switch, like I was explaining with these high ones, you cannot get them even if you run up the walls. So just whip it and voila. And this is what's really cool about this game. It's like they come out with these brand new mechanics that you can destroy enemies with. So what you can do is when they drop their, these guys drop their tails, you do that, and then you give them a fatal blow. So you whip them, drag into you, and then use a fatal blow. Now let's see, I'm trying to remember what else we need to do. Oh, I forgot about that treasure chest down there. Shit. Okay, yeah. We need to go down these vines. Let go. Grab on. Let go. And then raise another column. So now we can go up there. And you're gonna see why I wanna go up there, so. Oh yeah. So whenever you whip it, you want to swing your sword downward. So just keep that in mind. Once it latches, you swing your Wiimote down. And if you're gonna switch it again, you whip it up. Oh, look at that. There's a small chest right there. I wonder if there's any other treasure chest that I missed. Why wouldn't you go up, Link? I guess you can't. Let's see. Go, go, go. Yeah. Alright. So, get that. Now I want to get that treasure chest, though. Oh, I see how. And since we already activated that switch, by all means, if you miss that treasure chest like I didn't even want it, there's ways to get back up. Like, to get it, you need the whip to get it, and then, that same way that we went to go fight that mini-boss to get the whip, you don't, it's not timed or anything, so, if you need to go out, get some hearts, whatever, by all means, do it, and then just come back, and then just go into it. Alright, so here's the treasure chest. And we got the map. can't believe that I did not go out to get that. It's not like me. See, so the ancient cistern is made up of like three different areas, I believe. 1, 2, 3, 4. Actually, 5 areas. We're not even gonna worry about the enemy. They're too easy. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go all the way to the entrances to the middle of the statue. And we're gonna go inside it and see what the bottom part holds for us. So let's check it out. Whoops. You thought I was gonna go kersplat, huh? Alright, so with these guys, I'll tell you now, they're a bit of a pain in the ass. So if you want, by all means, fight them. But they're just gonna be respawning. That's the only problem with these guys. So let's see. We need to go over here, I think. Yep, exactly over here. Hold on one second. Right. There you go. Let's see. Oh yeah. Good thing about these lily pads, they're not gonna sink on you, so stand in the middle, bring out your beetle, and this statue here, you want to take him in the eyes, and you hit this little thing here, and that will deactivate that. And with that being said and done, we go to where the waterfall of evil is, kill all the evil bats, collect all their money and their heart. I didn't show you guys this in the Skyview Temple, but what you do is whenever you see a cluster of butterflies, anywhere, whether it's for a statue or the wall, you strum. And if you see a goddess wall, that's what I'm gonna call it. I don't know what they're actually called in this game. And you do a skyward strike kind of deal. And then you just draw whatever you want. Like, if you want hearts, you draw a heart. I want full life. So let's see. You draw hearts, and it'll give you hearts. If you draw rupees, they give you rupees. If you draw bombs, it'll give you bombs, and so on. So, just keep that in mind. So if you're running out of a certain thing and no enemies have dropped what you needed, the goddess walls are perfect for replenishing, especially in stuff like if you're playing hero mode, where you cannot get hearts unless you have a medallion and whatnot. If you don't have one by the time you're here and you see a goddess wall, you draw hearts and you get hearts. So just keep that in mind. It saved me through a lot of heartache whenever I was playing this game in hero mode. Because I 100%ed this game on hero mode. So, like, I was originally planning to do it in hero mode, but, like, this LP. But I just figured, like, it's probably going to be a little too difficult, and I might give up on it too easily. Because it literally took me, like, 3 months to complete this in hero mode. And gave up. That's how difficult it is. So I just figured I will tell you what's needed to know in hero mode. what you need to do and shit like that. So just keep that in mind. And so yeah, after you turn the spinning thing, the spinning turbine, I think, you just run this way, and then you want to get on this column here, and it's going to lead you to this side. And what you want to do is go up here. You're pretty much going to go on the opposite side of where you were to turn the turbine, and you do the same thing. Oh, come on. There you go. And so with that being said, this will allow us to go back this way, but instead of having to go back where we were, we're gonna, let's see. Damn it, dude. You have to do that now? Some dude is freaking using his freaking weed eater little machine thing. And it's making too much noise that my microphone's gonna be picking up. Alright, so once you're here, what you're gonna do is that you're gonna climb up. And yes, enemies are gonna be coming after you. But not to worry, because you're gonna be able to shake them off, so. Once they grab onto you, just shake the Wiimote. And once they drop, you just keep going up until you reach the end. And there you go. Now you don't have to worry about those guys going back down. That's the only problem, is that we're gonna have to go back down. So you just activate this switch. And then with that lever right there, you want to do the same thing, but you move it up. And so that will take us to where we need to go. We're almost done with this, guys. So with that being done, jump down. Oh shit. There you go. And now we go this way, and you can activate this if you want. I'm just gonna do it for the sake of completion, but you don't have to. It's just like if you want to go back or something, I don't know. I don't know why they would put that after you do everything, you know? I don't know. Like, it's just dumb. So you just go down, open the chest, and there you go. You got the Blessed Idol. This carved wooden statue looks like it's supposed to be to inspire gratitude. It also looks like the stone statue on the upper floor. And now all the enemies spawn, and the statue is going to fall on us. You just run, and then there you go. We're safe. And those assholes get crushed to death. Damn, bro. That's gotta suck getting crushed by that. And so we're done with everything else. Now the only thing we have to do is just go to the boss. So let's go up to the uppermost part of the ancient cistern and see what Holt is in store for us. What kind of boss is in this game? I'm not gonna tell you, but this is my favorite boss. So what you do with this idol is that you flip it inward, and then you're pretty much making a flower. The thing rotates, stops, and boom. Flower, that's a lotus. I completely forgot. Lotus is different than flower. I haven't really done much research on Alotus, but I gotta tell you, Alotus is a really beautiful plant. Flower, whatever. And so you just, here after you reach all the way to the top, you go back to all the bombs, and you go all the way to the top. This guy's a freaking giraffe. Buddha. Buddha is a giraffe. Now let's just save. You certainly are persistent. I'm terribly busy trying to find the clues that will help me revive the Demon King. Your incessant buzzing around my head like some irksome gadfly when I'm this busy is, well, it's making me very disagreeable. He disappears. So who are we fighting? Oh shit. This guy. And welcome guys to this is my favorite boss in this game. It's a very easy boss. And I'll show you exactly how to kill this motherfucker. So be ready. Alright. So make sure the Wii U is strapped onto your wrist. So now you get as close as possible to where he's gonna be attacking, and then you do backflips. You take out your whip, and then you break his arm. And so you do this repeat process until all of his arms are destroyed. And then with that, you can just go and unleash an attack on his chest. So as long as you're slashing his chest, you don't have to worry about the blades on his hands, because that'll just make him flinch. And just in case, you want to make sure you know what direction you're going to be jumping. And so, just repeat. Guard down, you whip him, and you break his arm. Alright. See, like, it takes a little bit longer to do that if you're not quick enough. And then just go in and slash his chest. And there you go. We're up to round two. And you just run like maniac, and you don't have to look to see where he's at or if he's swinging. You just run until you see the screen shaking, and that'll tell you that he dropped his guard. You quickly turn around and you rip his arms out. So we're done with round three. And this time he's gonna be a little bit harder, so make sure you're in the outward most part of this place. Then you just jump around until he's done swinging his sword. And then you get as close as possible until he's about ready to swing. Oh yeah, I forgot. He spawns enemies. There you go. Ready for another beating? Whoa! That's something you want to be careful with too, because he's gonna get a lot quicker with his swinging. Oh shit. I was hoping I would not take hit. Alright, I need to run. Alright. You want to make sure you cut his legs whenever he lets his guard down. Because with that, his... Damn it, why can I not hit him? Alright. Well, whenever you cut his legs, you want to hit him, horizontally. And then with that, it'll just drop him, and you don't have to worry about him swinging as long as you're swinging his chest, you know? Come on, bud. I know you want to. Come on, bud. Come on, bud. I know you want to swing it. Oh my god, he hit me. There you go. Oh shit, we missed one. That's okay, because we got one of his weapons. Come on. Let your guard down. And then go in and swing. 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 And there you go. That is the boss of the Ancient Cestern. Damn. Damn. And there you go, we get a heart container. Not a heart piece, a heart container. Alright, and since we have a little bit of time, let's see what this door has in store for us. So you come here, and you strike it. This is really cool. I love how the flames look. They go fine. Could've killed this fire. Raise your sword, master. I thought that was pretty cool how they do that. I mean, what happens with the sword? Oh shit, change forms. The flames of Pharaoh have improved your sword, making it longer and sharp enough to do twice as much damage. So we're gonna be doing twice the damage now. Which is really good, because we're gonna need it. And there's Link looking like a badass.
Huh?
There's his hand glowing. The first of the Triforce. The sacred flame has purified your blade, enhancing and evolving it.
Hey!
Evolving it. With your sword now in hands, you are ready to learn a new melody.
Hey!
We should return to the Isle of Songs. Alright, we will do that.
Hey!
And yes, I do want to save my progress. Oh shit. Ah, the sword you carry is different.